Making proposals sucks. Can Proposify help? Let's go find out. Proposify is a proposal software that claims to take the chaos out of creating and sending proposals. It claims to remove bottlenecks and add visibility to the closing process in your sales cycle. All right, let's get started on the review of Expensify. That's not right. Let's try that again. Begin our review of Chicken Pot Pie. What the f***? Begin our review of Lullaby. Oh, jeez. Stir Fry. Alumni. Black Eye.
Ow.
Tie Dye. Tough Guy.
War Cry.
Butterfly. Proposify. Let's go. Say goodbye to proposal chaos forever. Can start a free trial. No credit card required. That's what we like to see up in here. Welcome to Proposify, Will. Are you ready to see what the excitement is all about? I like it how it guides you through the product. Big fan of that. Integrations, Salesforce, HubSpot, Pipe Drives. All right, so let's build our first template, shall we? They've kind of got a gallery of templates for you to choose from as a starting point. So they've got ones for accounting, advertising, branding, construction, financial management, security services.
Management.
Financial portfolios, insurance,
computers.
Black leather gloves.
You can either start with one of these and make it your own, which will probably save you a lot of time. I'm gonna go ahead and try creating myself a template from scratch and see how I get on. I might regret that. Okay, wow, there is really nothing in here. You may be able to tell, based on what's behind me, that I'm a bit of a Star Wars fan. So instead of sending proposals on behalf of SalesFeed today, I'm gonna be sending proposals on behalf of one of the biggest ship manufacturers in the Star Wars universe, the Corellian Engineering Corporation. See how I get on. Okay, I am admittedly taking a little bit longer than I thought I would to make this template, but bear with me and I'll just zoom, zip right through this. I love it, I love it, I love it. Okay, and I'm done. That took a little bit longer than I expected. Now we've created that, I'll now actually be able to create a proposal from that template for a specific customer. So to do that, I integrated this with HubSpot, so I can like go in here and just press the create proposal button and it takes me to the same screen. However, it does look like they also have like a little mini kind of like company contact CRM within the platform as well. If you were like a really small business, you could probably just use this as your CRM because you don't need like deal management. If you connect it to your CRM, then you're able to import contacts from HubSpot and Salesforce and Pipedrive and whatever. But I'm gonna do it from Proposify on this one. So if I'm understanding this correctly, I click here and then I would select the template that I wanna use. This would be really useful because sometimes you need several different templates. If you're selling more than one product, then you might have like a template for your spaceships and a template for your Death Stars and all that stuff. Or maybe if you're selling to customers in like APAC or EMEA, you might need a different template for each of them with like different legal language. I'm just gonna use the one I just made. So then I can select my client, Darth Vader from the Empire, and connect that to a deal in HubSpot as well. Okay, and here we go. And the first thing I notice is that it's pulled in the client information, the Empire. So all that variable information, all the like placeholders in the template get filled in by the client information when you create the proposal. Typically in the past when I've sent proposals to people, what I've had to do is just have a template and then go in and change the client details every single time, which one takes absolutely ages, but two, one time I sent a proposal to a customer that had the wrong logo on it. Not only was it not their logo and their details, it was their competitors and super embarrassing. So this would probably reduce the chances of that happening. Cover letter. So on my cover letters, I often like to include a business case. Another really cool way to do that is send a video alongside your proposal. Now, it looks like I'm gonna be able to embed a video directly in this proposal. So if I open up Vidyard, hey, good looking, I can start recording and I can record a video for Darth Vader. Hey, Darth, my name's Will. I'm the account executive. He's been working with your team on the new shipment of TIE Fighter project so you can reduce the onslaught of rebel attacks. And now that I've done that, I can click select video and then I can just select the video that I want to embed. And boom, now I've got a video of me actually inside the proposal talking directly to the decision maker. That's awesome. The template is really like the bare bones. You can actually drag and drop new stuff into the proposal. So I created this TIE interceptor page and then you can just drop that in the document. That content library would be really good if you had like a group of case studies. but you could choose and drag and drop the one that's most relevant to the client that you're sending it to. Your investment, okay, pricing. So this is pretty trendy. If I'm right in thinking, this is a dynamic table. So when I delete a zero off this, the entire table changes. Editable quantity, if I'm selling software and I'm selling 10 licenses or something to someone, they can just whack on a couple of extra licenses at the last minute before signing off on the document. The other one is optional fees. You can actually create formula in these as well. So in this case, the delivery fee is 15% of everything on here. That way, if he changes the amount or if I add any extra fees to this, it will always remain 15% of the total. I can discount the unit price by, let's say, 15%, 50%. It. Darth Vader's gonna see, oh look, I get 500 at full price, but if I wanna add any more, then there's an incentive to do so. So I'm kind of like upselling him by saying, hey, like the first 500 are this price. If you wanna order more, then they actually are half price. Fee library, recurring fees. So that means I could make it like a monthly fee. Right, that would be really useful if you were selling software, because then you could make it like per year. And then it would be really clear that like there's a one-time cost of this, but then the recurring costs are $200,000 a year. Nice. I love it. The fact that it's got e-signatures in it would probably mean that you could actually use this instead of DocuSign as well. I will send this to Darth Vader. Okay, so when I go to send it to him, I have a couple of options. I can send it in this branded email, or I can just copy the link from here. So if I want to send it to Darth Vader and Darth Sidious, I can just click that. I like the idea of a reminder email, because most of the time you do need to remind clients to send it. Send to client. Let's go incognito and take a look what Darth Vader sees when he gets this. Whoa, I just got a notification on my phone that Darth Vader viewed the proposal shipment of TIE photos. That was immediate. So let's pretend I'm Darth Vader. This is pretty cool. You can kind of jump around using these things on the left here.
Hey, Darth, my name's Will, I'm the...
And I just got another notification from Vidyard saying that someone's watched my video. These are the types of notifications you want to get, though. There's a GIF that I added as well. The idea of including a video in your proposal, if you're selling software, you can include like a little micro demo in the proposal, so that way if the person who you're sending it to hasn't seen a demo yet, they can get like the full picture really quickly. Here's that fee table. So we've got those optional fees, but we can also edit the quantity and whatnot. That's going to be super easy for Darth Vader to upsell himself as well. So you can actually comment on there as well. And then I just got another notification, Darth Vader left a note on the proposal. These notifications are good because it gives you an idea if the deal's moving forward or not. If I saw someone had opened the proposal, I would be really, really tempted to just give them a call. Try and close them while they've got the thing in front of them. Download PDF. So it's PDF. And then when I click on the video, oh, it actually takes me to Vidyard.
My name's Will.
So if Darth Vader is one of those old-fashioned fellas who likes to print stuff off and write on it, then you can still do that as well. Whoa, hang on a second. So Darth Sidious is currently viewing the cover section of this proposal, but it also tells me which sections Darth Vader looked at when he opened it the first time. Oh, and I can also see his comments here. That's really cool, because I think most e-signature platforms only tell you like that someone's opened it, but this actually tells you what pages they've spent time on. So then I sign. Initial, 44 million credits. I hope this isn't legally binding. I don't have that kind of money. I'm about to have a kid. Darth Vader signed the proposal, shipment of TIE fighters. It kind of feels like it actually just closed the deal. I'm like, I got the full story all on my phone. And then actually sent me and Darth Vader a PDF copy of the signed proposal as well. And look at that, it's marked as one. And it closed the deal in HubSpot for me as well. 100% close rate. And that is why you should subscribe to Sales Feed on YouTube, because I'm the best, all right? I have the metrics and the data to back it up. So subscribe for more sales tips and content. Let's take a quick look at pricing. There's the team plan and the business plan. So the team plan, $49 per user per month. What do you not get? Salesforce integration, it's fair. Approvals, onboarding, user roles and permission. Okay, so it looks like the next plan up would be for like sales managers who wanted like approved proposals before they got sent. $49 a month, pretty fair. How much is a DocuSign license? $15 per month, but you're limited to 5 a month. The next level up is $45 a month. Okay, so it looks like it's about the same, but DocuSign only do e-signatures. They don't have the videos, the content library. E-signatures is just like one small part of all this. So Proposify, let's talk about some pros and some cons. First up, some pros of Proposify. Pros of Proposify. Number one, it was actually really quick to generate a proposal once I had a template in place. Number two, it's a much better client experience than sending a PDF or like a DocuSign. They can watch videos, they can leave comments, they can like navigate, they can download as a PDF. Number three, the interactive pricing tables are really interesting, both for me trying to build a quote, I can see the live total so I don't have to keep calculating it, but also the optional and editable fees. I can imagine that leading to like some increased deal sizes and some easy upsells. The analytics are super duper awesome. I haven't seen anything that gives you that much information once you actually send something to someone. I got real-time notifications on my phone every single time they opened it, they commented on it, they downloaded it as a PDF. And lastly, they provide you a really awesome template library so that you have loads of inspiration and starting points to create proposals from. Let's talk about some cons of Proposify. On that note about the template library, creating a template from scratch was super time consuming. If you were a salesperson, I wouldn't recommend like taking 2 hours of your day to create a proposal template. That's just not a good use of your time. I would probably get someone in marketing or like sales support to help me out and make that template for me. And the only other con I can think of is when I was using it, it crashed once or twice. It's constantly saving, so you never lose any work, but I had to refresh the page and get back on it. Would I use this? 100%. Thanks so much for watching. As always, I've left a link to the tool right below this. See you next time.